Pico, today we learn about questions and negations. Let's start. The word no conveys negation. Used as an interjection, no means the same as it does in English, no. No can be used as a modifier, for example, mi li lamo no, I am not tall. So, negations just work by putting no behind the word you want to negate. So, what would sili toki noki mi mean? It means you do not talk to me. And now try to translate this complex English sentence into Tokima. He isn't good because he doesn't have time. The correct translation is un li pona no, nente un li yo no e tempo. This is a sneak peek of the word te, which we will examine in further detail later. Now to questions. For yes or no questions, you can use a normal sentence like you are short and end it with anu no. So, sili tini anu no means you are short or not. Or in better words, are you short? Now try out asking, do you have bread? It's sili yo epan anu no. Furthermore, there is also the word semi, which basically asks the question, what should be in this spot of the sentence? For example, simili toki means who, what is talking. Sili toki nen seme means you are talking because of what, or in better words, why are you talking? Ultimately, seme is used similarly like what in English. You can see in both of those examples that the question is really just asking for the noun that fits in the spot seme occupies. Also, you can use seme as a modifier too. For example, Jan seme would be what human, that is who, and into or ma seme, literally what place, would mean where. What do you think does Jan litawa tan ma seme mean? It means the person is coming from what country? Now try saying who is this person, like what person is this person? It should be something like Yan seme li yan ni in Tokima. And now our vocabulary will be about animals and some other words. We all love animals, but having many words for them is tough in any language. In Tokima there are 13 words for animals. Aketi for reptiles, lizards, snakes, crocodiles. Kala for fish. Keke for primates, monkeys and chimpanzees. Kita for ungulates like elephants, deer or other large mammals. Mea for cat-like animals like cats, lions, tigers. Misa for rodents like mice and hamsters. Mu for bovide like cows, goats and sheep. Nehe for equide like horses, donkeys and zebra. Pao for dog-like animals like dogs, wolves and bears. Pipi for insects, so really for all mammals, you should already know this word. Waso for birds, Yanua for all animals. Many of these words try to sound like the animal, like mea and pao. This means that certain animals can at least speak one word of Tokima. For every other animal, if you want to be very specific, you can use scientific names for it. For example, apis means bee, so you can say pipi apisi. We will teach you later how to translate foreign names to Tokima. Now the rest of the vocabulary. Isun, market, shop, finance. Into, place, space, point, zone, room, area, region. Kanti, song, music, poetry. Kili, fruit. Lon, real, true, to exist, to be. Meli, female, feminine. Mie, male, masculine. Tonsi, trans, gender non-confirming or non-binary. Pulono, old, ancient. Talika, list, series, table, chart, data. That's it for this episode. I hope you had fun and goodbye, Militawa.